When Bryony Kerwood stopped feeling her unborn baby kicking, she visited the hospital just to be safe. However, she may never have expected just how serious the situation was. And following an initial scan, Bryony's medical team knew they needed to get her into surgery as quickly as possible. Bryony herself, meanwhile, lives with husband Mike in Cleethorpes in the north of England. There, she works as a beauty therapist. Mike, on the other hand, is a heating engineer. The couple had wanted new roles for a long time. However, simply put, they were eager to become parents. Indeed, Bryony and Mike had even been trying for a baby for some months before their wedding in 2015. So, when Bryony finally fell pregnant with the pair's first child in 2016, she and her husband were presumably over the moon. What's more, the parents-to-be would eventually discover that they were expecting a little girl. And judging from Bryony's Facebook post, they couldn't wait to meet her. In one update, featuring a copy of the expectant mom's ultrasound, she even joked that she hoped the baby looked like her. However, little did Bryony and Mike know that they'd be seeing their daughter a lot sooner than planned. In particular, after Bryony suffered a fall 29 weeks into her pregnancy. And understandably, the couple were panic-stricken to find that their baby had stopped moving following the incident. As a result then, they rushed to Grimby's Diana, Princess of Wales Hospital, where doctors could monitor the situation. Then, after the pair had arrived at the hospital, doctors did all the relevant checks. The medical professionals were also keen for the couple to return in the following days. They put a heart monitor on her, assessed her, and then told us they'd like us to come back for a scan at 4 p.m. on Monday, Mike explained to the Grimsby Telegraph in December 2017. And Bryony subsequently attended that scan with her father, Andy Holmes. However, if she'd known how the ultrasound was about to go, she might have insisted on Mike being there. Why? Well, during the checkup, medical staff gave her some worrying news. In particular, doctors told Bryony that she would need to give birth as soon as possible, potentially even that very day. At first, though, the mom-to-be wasn't worried by this development. "I was excited at first because I thought I was going to see my baby," she told the Hull Daily Mail in December 2017. However, Bryony did the math and worked out that her daughter wasn't actually due for another 10 weeks, a fact that would soon change her mood. "I realized that it was way too early and I got really scared," the expectant mother confessed. At this point though, giving birth was her only option. That's because Bryony and Mike's unborn daughter had stopped growing in her womb. Unknown to the couple, and just a week after a routine scan, a problem with the placenta had prevented their baby from developing further. As a consequence then, the tot's life hung in the balance. So just hours after being told that terrifying news, Bryony found herself undergoing an emergency C-section. In the meantime, Mike had rushed to the hospital to be by his wife's side and to welcome their daughter, Ava, into the world. 2 hours after the baby was born, on December 19, 2016 though, she was separated from her parents and rushed to Hull's Women and Children's Hospital, some 30 miles away. Indeed, as Ava tipped the scales at a minuscule 1 pound 7 ounces, she needed specialist care like the kind provided by the Hull Hospital. The tiny infant was also suffering from further complications, including a shadow on her brain, all of which would also need expert attention. For Bryony though, being separated from her newborn was agony. "I didn't actually get to meet her for 4 days. It was horrible," she told the Grimsby Telegraph. "They tried to get me a bed in Hull and there wasn't one." So for 4 long days, Bryony recovered from her C-section in Grimsby while her baby underwent life-saving treatment in Hull. And in the middle of both of them, of course, was Mike. He had a mission on his hands too, though having been tasked with ferrying breast milk from Bryony to Ava. Explaining his daily routine, Mike revealed to the Grimsby Telegraph, "I drove down to see Ava every morning. I had to drive to Bryony in the hospital, pick up her breast milk, take it to my daughter in Hull, and then go to work. She was too small at this point to have any other milk." Thankfully though, all the couple's efforts paid off, as when Ava was almost 6 months old, doctors finally transferred her back to Grimsby. Then, 2 weeks after that, she was able to go home. And on December 19th, 2017, the infant celebrated her first birthday in perfect health. What's more, it was hard for Ava's parents to believe just how ill their baby had been following her birth. "It's weird now looking back because I remember it like, will she survive? Will she be all right? Or do we just take it minute by minute?" Bryony said to the Grimsby Telegraph. A year down the line, though, and it's hard to tell that Ava's been so close to death. There's obviously nothing wrong with her now, Mike revealed. She's got a slight problem with one of her eyes, but it's very minor and we're getting that sorted in January. Health-wise, there's actually nothing wrong with her, which is incredible. With Ava's health on the up then, the family were thrilled to spend Christmas at home together for the first time. I've had my tree up since the end of November because I just couldn't wait for us to begin the celebrations, Bryony admitted. Despite their excitement though, the family didn't forget to thank the people who had made their first family Christmas possible. Indeed, during the festive season in 2017, Bryony and Ava would return to the neonatal unit to visit staff and deliver presents to premature babies. And for her parents, little Ava is the perfect example of just how strong newborns can be, no matter how small they are.